Hey everybody, welcome to another WordPress Wednesday. My name is Kori Ashton here at WebTagrity in San Antonio, and you have found a YouTube channel solely dedicated to all things WordPress. We expound upon that though with some search engine optimization inside of your WordPress website and some social media marketing inside your WordPress website. So this channel is kind of a little bit of everything. And we've got stuff for all levels, total beginners to some really cool advanced nerdy stuff. So stick around with us, be sure to subscribe. Today we are going to be continuing our series on search engine optimization. Last week I spoke specifically on how to find keywords inside of your WordPress website. And the week prior to that, we spoke on optimizing your Google snippets. Super important that you do both of these. So check those videos out. I'll put the link to this whole playlist in the description box below because this playlist has 28 videos, some that I've done, some that I've resourced around YouTube and brought in for my clients to watch. And I think it's super important that our YouTube fans watch these as well. So take time to check out that playlist. Also, I have a Yoast playlist, and that is the plugin that we're going to be talking about today, specifically looking at the Readability tab. How important is that green light? What does it even mean? Should I be trying to get a green light in Readability? So take time if you want to look through these other Yoast videos. They're really a great resource as well. So let's look at it, y'all. The green light. How important is the green light when it comes to Readability? What does that area even mean inside of the Yoast plugin? So you know if you're using the Yoast plugin that as you activate it and start using it on your articles and pages, you have the SEO option to get to the green light, and that's really exciting because it's analyzing your content, letting you know that Google can clearly understand what this page is about. However, there's a secondary tab that talks about the readability. Now, the readability certainly is a second level of concern, if you will. However, I think it is something that we should pay attention to. Now, should we strive to get to the green light? I know there's a temptation for everybody to say, well, I must get to a green light. Well, specifically readability has a different concern to it. What they're looking at is perhaps some more grammar issues, maybe just how simple is it to kind of read down your paragraph. So let's analyze a few and get some ideas of exactly what they're complaining about when they're giving us a green or a red light, rather. Let's go in and see this article. One thing I want you to note right away is it's fantastic when it comes to the SEO side of things. It has over 800 words in this particular article, and he has optimized his Google snippet as well. So all of this looks fantastic. However, we've got a big old red glaring at us, red light over here for readability. So coming in here, it allows us to understand a little bit more why they're grading us like this. It's telling us that 31.3% of sentences contain more than 20 words, which is more than the recommended of 25%. So try to shorten the sentences. So basically it's just saying, hey, you know, you might be a little wordy. You've got maybe some run-on sentences. Take a look and try to shorten them out just a little bit. That's a nice little tip. All right, so 20% of the sentences contain passive voice, which is more than recommended. Try using their active counterparts. So again, these are things that your grammar teacher back in fifth grade would have had her red or his red ink pen out circling your paper, giving you the same feedback. And I know that that's irritating at times. However, it's going to help overall your user have a better experience when reading down these longer articles. Here's some other things that they're kind of asking us to pay attention to. So I'll put the link to this article in the description box below as well, because this is directly from the Yoast website. I'm going to scroll down here to the readability tab issue, and it tells us the different things that it is analyzing on your page. And that again is sentence length, paragraph length. So if your paragraphs are a little too lengthy, they're going to kind of gripe at us there. And I think that's what this little orange concern is, telling us that it has more than 150 words in this one paragraph. Can you consider possibly shortening it? So good advice. There's that passive voice again. Oh, here's this. I don't want to miss this because this is important. They want to see those subheadings kind of break up the paragraphs as you scroll down the page. It's important to allow our eyes to rest for a minute, and subheadings do that. Transition words like however and therefore, those are great to read. And then also the reading ease. So this is talking basically about the reading level of the average person in the US. So we're looking at 7th and 8th grade reading level these days. That's the average reading level. What this is basically doing though, and here's what I want you to note. This is a very broad, general, overall, hey, you should be writing to this age level or this readability level. What I want you to understand, though, and something that this particular client even struggles with, is the fact that sometimes he has to get a little technical. And he knows that his audience is okay with that because that's what they're researching. So depending upon what you're writing about and who you're writing to, I want you to always be aware that content is first. I know there's a temptation to get to this green light. We want to see these green lights everywhere. But the truth is, content is first. So be sure to write to your audience and then go back and allow this little system here, this readability tab, to kind of grade you and steer you and maybe some corrections that you can move toward to getting a green light. Does that make sense? It is important. I want you to take time to understand how to get green lights. And so because of that, I will put this link as well as a few others in the description box below. But I am going to also link to this, the Temptation of Green Bullet in the Yoast SEO plugin. Because they too speak to the fact that a lot of people are so anxious about getting everything possible to green and what's the reality of it, what's the importance of it. So accountability is great and having those green lights are fantastic. I challenge all my clients to take a screenshot of their green lights and send them to me as they've worked hard to earn those. However, understanding what your audience is looking for is even more important. So be sure to have a healthy balance. If you have questions about this, give us a shout out over on Twitter. Come over to webtegrity.com. Give me an email. Put a comment in the thread below. However I can help, I'd love to be your SEO nerd. All right, have a great one, and I will see y'all next WordPress Wednesday. Bye, everyone.